Hello, my name is Geoff Marshall Taylor and welcome to this time of reflection. Well, over the last few months, I don't know about you, but one of the things I've been doing stuck at home was to sort through things that we've had around the house for ages in boxes, cupboards and so on. And on New Year's Eve, I was doing some of this sorting and I came across this. It's a stone, a flat stone. And when I saw it, it brought back lots of wonderful memories because I picked it up from the beach in North Devon, a place called Lee Abbey. Actually, the bay is called Lee Bay, and it's in a wonderful setting. It's the tiniest of coves. And when you go to stay at Lee Abbey, which is a Christian conference centre, the grass sweeps down across fields to the bay, and that's where I found this. But it's not all, it's not just an idyllic setting. About 100 yards from the bay, there's a tea bar, a coffee bar, or a coffee shop, and it used to be run by a lady called Ursula, and she's passed away now, but Ursula was fantastic. She knew all about the flora, the fauna, in that most beautiful of areas in North Devon. Anyway, the other things she was good at, not just making scones and cups of tea, but was painting. And she painted the other side of the stones we found in the bay. And there it is. She's painted the bay, surrounding it with wild pink roses. Ursula was fantastic, and she transformed a very ordinary looking stone into something beautiful, or she put it, something beautiful for God. Well, as I was thinking on New Year's Eve about the stone and the way that Ursula transformed something very ordinary into something special, I began to think that all around the country and the world, people were, that night, New Year's Eve, thinking of ways that they might change, where they made resolutions about the future. And for Christians, one of those resolutions has to be to long and pray for God to transform us. And there's a verse in the letter of Paul to the Romans that sums up this challenge. How far can I be transformed by God? And this is what it says. It's Romans chapter 12. Brothers and sisters, in view of God's mercy, offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. That is your true and proper worship. And then there come some words that really hit home for me as I was thinking of it on New Year's Eve. Do not conform to the pattern of the world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you'll be able to test and approve what God's will is. His good, pleasing, and perfect will. What God wants is for our lives to be transformed into the likeness of Jesus. And that can only happen when we let His Spirit change us from within, starting by the renewing of our minds. In one sense, that Lee Bay stone was transformed by Ursula's painting. But the scene is only superficial. Its essence is that it's a pebble, whereas St. Paul wants us to be transformed from within, capable of being changed daily by God. The late David Pawson was a well-known minister at Gold Hill Baptist Church. And I once heard him preach a cracking sermon on these words: don't be conformed to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your minds. Well, put it this way, he said, don't be a chameleon, be a caterpillar. Don't be a chameleon, be a caterpillar. The chameleon takes on the colours of its surroundings. The caterpillar, though, is transformed from within through all the stages of its development, from the egg through the caterpillar stage, then the chrysalis, and then, wonder of wonders, the glorious butterfly that emerges. Its very essence develops and is transformed, is regenerated from within. That's our challenge, to let God transform us until we take on the Christian family likeness, the likeness of Christ. Now let's pray together as we look ahead to this year with all its uncertainty. Let's put this in the hands of our Lord, our Heavenly Father. Let's pray. Lord, who can make all things new, transform my mind that I may respond to the challenges of your Holy Spirit. Lord, who can make all things new, transform my heart that I may respond to the love of your Holy Spirit. Lord, who can make all things new, transform my will that I may respond to the challenges of your Holy Spirit. Amen. So may the Lord bless you and keep you today and every day in the coming year. Amen.